you have a commercial solar project and it's time to select the cables. You're looking at volt rise, you're looking at current can capacity. Well, what else do you have to look at? Dally here from Greenwood Solutions. This week we're looking at cables, specifically for a 300 kilowatt plus commercial solar system. After watching the video, you'll understand what standards to reference, what to look for when selecting a cable, and how to derate a cable depending on its location and method of installation. Now, if you like what you see, hit that subscription button. And if you've got some friends who are interested in renewable energy, tell them to hit the subscription button too. Let's get stuck into it. When it comes to selecting the right cable for a DC or AC application on your next commercial solar project, the standard approach is to calculate what current will be carried through the cable, work out the cable run distances, then the volt drop on the DC and the volt rise AC particulars. For an example, in AS4777, the example reference table 7, column 24, is in regards to current can capacity, and then another table for the millivolt per amp meter factor used to determine the voltage rise on the AC side. This example isn't worst case scenario, but is close. But what if we need more specific detailed information that has to be passed on to the distributor for the project? For example, not only the cable you're installing, but the cable already there. What then? In this presentation, we're going to look at an actual case study of a 300 kilowatt plus system. We are systematically going to go through all the calculations from the inverter via the GridSafe to the MSB to the transformer. We look at the current carrying capacity of the cables and how their method of installation affects this current carrying capacity. So what inverters are we using on this site? Inverter number one is a 100 kilowatt inverter. Inverter number two is also 100 kilowatt. Inverter number three is 29.9 kilowatts. And inverter number four is 40 kilowatts. I probably should have got the 40 and the 29.9. To determine the actual current outputting from these inverters, the calculation is as follows. Very important, the nameplate rating in kVA of the inverter divided by, in brackets, the nominal voltage, in this case 400 volts, three phase, times the square root of 3, close bracket. So number one, first inverter is 100 kilowatt, but it's actually got 105 kVA rating. So we go through the calculation, and that gives us 151.55 amps. Number two is 44 kilowatt, but has a 44 kVA rating. So we go through the calculation, gives us 63.51 amps. Now number three is 29.9 kilowatt, and also is 29.9 kVA, go figure. And that gives us a figure of 43.16 amps. So a grand total of 409.77 amps output under normal conditions. And here are the results in a table. So you can see inverter number one, it's 100 kilowatt, 105 kVA, inverter number two, etc., number three and number four. Combined total of 409.77 amps. But where in the whole system are we seeing 409.77 amps? Now this particular configuration involves the following. The four inverters all cabled to a secondary protection board, in this case of course a Greenwood Solutions GridSafe board. The secondary protection board acts as a PVDB and connects to the main switchboard. In regards to the 409.77 amp we are looking at, this only applies from the GridSafe to the MSB and, if all loads are off, out through to the grid. This means that all the cabling from the GridSafe main switch, a motorised MCCB, must be able to cope with this current. We will assume that the existing cable between the MSB and POA or transformer is more than sufficient from a current carrying capacity perspective, so we don't have to worry about it for now. We will still have to do some volt rise calculations, but later on. Let's have a look at the inverter's cabling requirements. The maximum distance from the last inverter to the PVDB is 15 metres and from the PVDB to the MSB is 20 metres. As we are using three by different capacity inverters, the inverters with the highest capacity ideally will be installed closest to the GridSafe. This will play a role when we are looking at the volt rise calculations required. Got it? Now we look at how the cabling is being installed. We've decided to install 300mm cable tray affixed to the wall and we'll be using lid to enclose everything. So what cable do we use? Now the standard for general cabling is AS3008 and in this case we'll be referencing the latest iteration 2017. We have selected the cable support that will be 300mm cable tray with a lid and for ease of convenience we are using 4-core and earth multi-core. The insulation type is X90 XLPE, which is a higher current rating than thermoplastic. In this case, we look at table 14, column 11, and we find that 70mm squared cable will be sufficient for us as it has a 173 amp rating and the 100 kVA output is 151.55 amps. So we've selected the cable based on the current carrying capacity of the inverter output with the installation method and location taken into account. But is there more? Yes, unfortunately. We have to look at the derating factor of the proximity to cables or circuits. In other words, other cables or circuits. In this case, in the same tray. Now we will have four by separate multi-core cables, one for each inverter, all in the same tray. So we have to look at table 22, column 7, item 2, where we discover a derating factor of 0.65 because there's four inverters, each classed as a separate circuit. So we have 151.55 amps per phase max output from inverter. Because we are installing the cable between the inverter and the PVDB, the grid safe, in tray with lid, and there are three other inverters, we have to derate by 0.65, which is huge. So the cable we select has to be able to cope with 151.55 divided by 0.65, and that's 233.2 amps. So back to table 14, column 11, we find that 120mm squared XLPE 90 degree will do the trick. Note, also have to remember to coordinate the breaker with the cable. We go through the process for the other inverters. For the 44 kVA inverter, it's 63.51 amps and we derate by 0.65, that gives us 97.7 amps and that cable will do 114 amps. With the 29.9 kilowatt inverter, it's 43.16 amps and we derate by 0.65, that's 66.4 amps. 16mm cable will do 68 amps, so all good so far. Now from the grid safe to the MSB. All the cables have been run into the grid safe and the cumulative current of all the inverters is 409.77 amps. We have to go through the same process now. And we'll be using single core XLPE as the multi-core option is too cumbersome and is hard to handle. Also, we will be installing in ladder horizontally with no lid, so heat dissipation will be less of an issue compared with the run in vertical tray with lid between the inverters and the PVDB. So we have to look at COM 15, table 8, and 300mm squared will do 469 amp, so that's all good. Now have to look at derating. As we are installing the single core cable in horizontal ladder in the air with no lid, we have to reference a different derating table, which in this case is table 23. Now there's only one circuit, so no derating. And in fact, as the installer has spaced the cables, ideally, there would be no derating even if there are other circuits. See clause 3.5.2.2C and figure 1A in AS3008. The outcome is that we can use the 300mm squared cable selected. Now, the cable or cables from the MSB to the pad mount transformer is something we don't change. In this example, the existing cable arrangement is 8 by single core 300mm squared aluminium 90 degree rating. So no problems with the cable's ability to handle 409.77 amps. Let's have a look at the table. In the first column, we have the inverter number, and then we have the capacity in the next column, output, current after derating, the cable selected, the total current from the grid safe to the MSB, the cable selected after derating for that run from the grid safe to the MSB, and the cable from the MSB to the transformer. Now, AS4777 stipulates a max volt rise of 2% from inverter with largest volt rise calculation all the way through to the transformer in this case. Now, as we are talking about three phase, the 2% applies to 400 volt nominal, and this equates to 8 volts. So the designer has only 8 volts to play with, and really their choices are limited to the cabling between the inverters and the grid safe, and between the grid safe and the MSB. You don't really want to muck around with the cabling between the MSB and the transformer. Now, there is a few ways to calculate voltage drop. AS4777 references the millivolt per amp meter method that produces a conservative result. The other method we will look at in our next presentation uses the circuit impedance method. Step by step. Step 1. Determine the max output of the inverters combined and their individual ratings using the KVA rating from the data sheet. Step 2. Select conductor type and form. Example, copper XLPE for inverter to GridSafe and single core from GridSafe to MSB. Step 3. Select circuit breaker size based on derate factor. Example, current output times 1.25. Step 4. Select installation location method via correct table in AS3008. Example, table 14, column 11 for multi-core on vertical tray with lid. Step 5. Select cable size from correct AS3000 tables for multi-core and single core, and it must exceed the CB rating. Step 6. Make sure the current carrying capacity of cable selected is derated according to the appropriate derating table. Conclusion. This area of correct cable selection to satisfy current carrying capacity, voltage rise and cable costing economics relies on AS3008. The ability to understand this standard is of paramount importance. The correct current must be assessed every step of the way. And as we have seen, the method installation, location, and derating factors really affects this initial, or should I say, final figure. Thanks so much for watching our presentation on the current carrying capacity of cables for a 300 kilowatt system. I'm Valley from Greenwood Solutions. Now, if you like what you see, hit that subscription button. And if you've got any inquiries, any questions, or even any answers, feel free to drop us a line and see you next time.